How's it going, everyone? Welcome to another free songwriting lesson. My name is Matthew McCloskey, and today we're going to be taking a look at Chandelier by Sia. I'm going to be showing you the top three tricks that Sia uses in this song that make it a success, and showing you how you can use those exact same tricks and techniques in your songwriting to take your craft to the next level. Let's get into it. So the first thing Sia does in this song that makes it a success is its chord progression. This is the chord progression from the verses. It goes B flat minor, party girls don't get hurt, can't feel anything. That's on a G flat. When will I learn? I push it down, A flat, I push it down, I push it down. F minor right here at the end. This chord progression works really well because it's asymmetrical. Something is asymmetrical when it's not the same if you split it down the middle on both sides. So this line that I've drawn splits this progression down the middle, and as you can see, we've got different chords on both sides of this. B flat minor and G flat up here, A flat and F down here. If this chord progression were symmetrical, this would need to be an A flat, and this would need to be an F minor. It's like a mirror, right? If you split it down the middle and it mirrors the same on both sides, then it's a symmetrical chord progression, and that's not good. Why is that not good? It's because if the chord progression is predictable and it doesn't change, your audience is going to get used to it, and they're not going to want to listen to your song as much because your song is kind of just doing the same thing over and over and over again. You have to remember to change your chords up, not just in each section, but you have to change your progression going from one section to another. So as you go from a verse into a pre-chorus, you have to change your progression again. And Sia does that. When she gets to the chorus, she doesn't use this same progression over again. She goes G flat, A flat, F minor, G flat, which is different. That's how she keeps this chord progression fresh, even though she's using the exact same chords. Now let's say you really, really like this progression, and you want to use it in your own music, but you don't want to use these exact ones because you feel like you're ripping Sia off. How do we do something similar? We move this progression into another key. How do we do that? We do that using the Nashville number system. There's a download in the description of this video that's going to show you how to use the Nashville number system in your own music. Go grab that. It's helped me a ton in my writing. I know it can do the same for you too. What I'm going to do is walk through it here. The first thing we have to do when we're using the Nashville number system is figure out what key we're in. I'll tell you, for this song, we're in D flat. So D flat is our one. Once we know D flat is number one, we can figure out the numbers for all of these chords. I'll just write them down here. B flat minor is your minor six, G flat is your four, A flat is your five, F minor is your minor three. Now that we have those numbers, all we need to do is pick another key, and we can move these numbers into that key, and we have a brand new progression. So let's choose G, for example. G's easy, we can use G. So in G, your minor six is an E minor, your four is a C, your five is a D, and your minor third is a B minor. Now that you have these chords, you have a brand new progression that's really similar to Sia's, but it's not in the same key. So you can write something with a similar feel and a similar chord progression without ripping Sia off. This is a great way to bring in influences from artists that you admire without mimicking them too closely, because if someone hears this progression, they might think, oh, you ripped that off from Sia. But if you put this in a different key, they might be like, huh, that sounds cool. So again, grab that download in the description if you want to learn how to do this. It's helped me a ton. I know it can help you guys in your songwriting. So the second thing that really helps make this song a success is the structure Sia uses in her chorus. This chorus is a really, really great structure, and like we talked about before, it's asymmetrical. If you set up a pattern, the way Sia does here, she says, okay, I'm going to start with one long A line that's got a rhyming word at the end right here, chandelier, and then I'm just going to repeat it again like she does here. I'm going to live like tomorrow doesn't exist, which kind of rhymes with chandelier, it's close enough. Like it doesn't exist. If you set up that pattern, what people are expecting in this third line right here is another one of these. But Sia knows that. And so the way she keeps you engaged and the way she keeps your ear tuned into the song is she gives you four quick B lines that all rhyme with each other. You're expecting to have to wait until here to hear the rhyming word, but Sia says, no, I'm going to give you four words real quick that rhyme with each other. I'm gonna fly like a bird through the night, feel these tears as they dry. That is the line right here that really keeps this chorus fresh. And then, once we've gone through that, Sia brings us back to something familiar and hits us with, I'm gonna sing from the chandelier, from the chandelier. Where I've underlined right here, these four spots are the tag. That's when Sia says the name of the song, chandelier. And remember, when you're writing a chorus, you want to repeat your tag as many times as possible. So it's good to have a short one like chandelier, because you can put it in more places. Four times to say the title of the song in your chorus is really good. Most songs get like one or two tops, and Sia knows that. So to help you remember the song better, she puts her tag in four times in her chorus. One last thing that I really, really like about this chorus structure is the relation between these long A's and then a short A right here. We talk about asymmetry, remember? Where you split something down the middle and it's not the same on both sides. But you can do that with lines too. If we split this down the middle, is it the same on both sides? No, because you can't split this line in half. I mean, even if you did, you'd have one A that sort of cuts off right here in the middle, and then you'd have a fragment of a phrase right here and then this little short A right here. It's imbalanced. And that's good, because if all of your phrases, let's say that this A right here is one phrase, and this A is a phrase, if these two phrases were the same length, it would be balanced. And your audience would know exactly how long Sia is going to sing for, when she's going to start, and when she's going to stop. When you change it up like this, where you've got one long line, the audience might be expecting another long line after that. But she instead gives them a little short one. To keep it even more fresh, Sia makes this melody line right here go a little bit higher than the last one. Remember? Because it's, I'm gonna swing from the chandelier, from the chandelier. She goes higher on this one. That keeps this little line distinct from this line. By going a little bit higher, the melody's different. That's why this structure works so well. This line is distinct from this one, and then these lines are distinct from this one. There's a lot happening here to keep the chorus fresh. So remember that when you're writing. Look for opportunities to keep your structure, whether it be for your chorus or for your verses, look for ways to spice it up and keep it fresh, because that is what is going to keep your audience listening. The third thing about this song that makes it a success are its lyrics. What I want to talk about here is the idea of conflict between feelings and actions. Most songs have a protagonist. The main character of the song. It could be an I, it could be a you, it could be a he. In this case, it's an I. It's Sia herself in this song. In the beginning of the song, she's talking about her feelings, right? Party girls don't get hurt, can't feel anything, when will I learn? I push it down, I push it down. Those words are about someone living in denial. There's a pain. If you're pushing something down, it's usually an emotion or a feeling that you don't want to look at. Which is the exact wrong thing to do with emotions. You're supposed to process them so they can leave your body. When you start pushing them down, weird, bad things happen. So someone has hurt Sia, right? We don't know all the details as to why or how, but she's been hurt and she's pushing those feelings down. She's feeling hurt, but then her actions are different. She goes out and she parties, right? One, two, three, drink. When you're feeling sad, do you really want to go out and party? No. But you do it to suppress those feelings. You don't want to feel sad, and so when you go party. That's the conflict between how you're feeling, super sad, and what you actually do. I'm going to go party because I don't want to feel like this. Why does that work so well? Because human beings are irrational. I'm irrational, you're irrational. All the time we have feelings that conflict with our actions. We have stuff that we want to do, and then the stuff we actually do. And when those two conflict with each other, there's all sorts of nasty stuff and uncomfortable, sad stuff that happens. Like in this song, for example, Sia captures that really well, because in the first half of the chorus, it's, I'm gonna swing from the chandelier. She's just owning it. She's partying. She's swinging from the chandelier. But then in the second half of the chorus, she kind of pulls in a little bit and she gets scared, like, won't let go, won't open my eyes, I'm just holding on for tonight. It's this really beautiful image of sort of realizing, like, holy crap, what have I gotten myself into? I shouldn't have listened to this action. I should have processed these emotions. And when you create a character in a song that has conflict between their actions and their emotions or their values, that makes them human. And if you can create a character that's human, it's going to resonate with the humans listening to it. So when you're writing, think about ways to create conflict. Set up a character, establish some values for that character. What does this character think is important? How is this character feeling? And then ask yourself, what should that character do? And then do the opposite thing. So if a character is feeling angry, the right thing to do would be to keep that anger controlled, find a way to like let it out constructively. So the opposite of that would be to go destroy some stuff, bash in a window, beat somebody up. That is going to make a really compelling song, and that's why Chandelier works so well. Thanks for checking this video out. I hope what I've explained here today has been useful to you and it's helped further your songwriting in some way. If anything I've covered in this video is unclear to you, or if there was something in this song that you want to hear me go into more depth on, send me a comment in the section. I read all of them and I want to make sure I'm helping you guys. Please subscribe to this channel for more videos in the future. I would love to have you guys along for the ride. If you have any ideas for songs that I can do in the future that you think are great, or artists that you think write really well, send me those in the comment section as well. I'm always on the hunt for new music that I can analyze for you guys. And lastly, make sure you grab that download of the Nashville Number System in the description. That's gonna help you a ton in your songwriting. My name is Matthew McCloskey. Thanks again for checking out this video, and I will see you guys next time.